And the last thing we'll talk about in terms of our collection system is the routing of the collection systems. And one of you asked about making collection schedules and routes in the intro forum. So hopefully this is interesting for you. But so on the screen is just an example of a route that a truck might run to be able to hit all the addresses on this street. And routing is kind of interesting because routing is the base of graph theory in mathematics. So there's this famous problem that Euler talked about, the bridges of Königsberg. And so there's this block of the city with 7 bridges, and he was thinking about what's the most efficient way to cross each bridge once, and can I do that without double crossing the bridges? And this led to this whole area of math called graph theory. And graph theory sets the kind of foundation of how we do route optimization today. So traditionally, waste routes have been planned heuristically, which means we just apply some rules of thumb and try and kind of figure out the best way just from experience and judgment. So there's a few kind of principles that you might follow that are shown on the screen there to try and develop the best heuristic route, but you're always not going to be as efficient as an automated computer system. So these days, instead of doing things manually and just guessing what's the best thing, there's all sorts of computer optimization programs that will look at where waste generators are, how much they generate each week, and how it varies throughout the year, and can generate optimized routes that will lower the amount of times that trucks have to go down routes, lower fuel consumption and stuff like that. So typically these kinds of studies can lower the operational expenses for routing by about 20%, which is substantial. And going even further than that, you can have GPS units on the trucks themselves that will change their routes in real time. So say one truck, they're picking up more waste volume than they thought they might be, they're going to have to go back to the transfer station sooner. A system can in real time look at what trucks are close and reroute them to finish up some of their routes. So kind of on the fly, be adjusting to the field conditions to make the waste collection work most efficiently on a continual basis. So there's a lot we can gain from kind of automation and in GIS in terms of the collection space. It's a really big job, so the more we make it efficient, then the more savings that the municipality or operator will have.